But here's one that will never go away in Canada, and this makes me so proud. We are a cultural mosaic, right? Ethnic diversity in this country is spectacular. I mean, especially here in Montreal. I mean, where else in the world can you go into an Irish pub, have a Sri Lankan guy make you the best damn sushi pizza you've ever had? Right here in Montreal, goddammit. I think it's amazing, right? But I can't, it makes sense in a big city like this, in Montreal. It makes perfect sense. But I come from tiny town Newfoundland. Like, I'm talking a town of 350 people. And there was a town nearby called Ticklemearmpits. Okay? And there was one little tiny Indian family that lived in this town. I was like, how the hell did they get here? Like, why, what? How does that happen? Most people go straight to Toronto or Montreal or maybe. No, they ended up in Ticklemearmpits. Like, what the hell? Like, were they this man back in India? And I guess he just applied for some job online as a teacher. It's like, I don't know, some place called Ticklemearmpits. And he doesn't think about it. He's like, oh, it's in Canada. And he's got the pamphlet. And he's like, look at the pamphlet, children. We're going to Canada. Look, it's so beautiful in Canada, right? With the mountains and you got the prairies and the sea and tower. Look at the sea down at the Niagara Falls and the lighthouse. It's Canada. Pack your bags and get into the tiny little car. We're going to Canada. And they go to the airport, right? And they all get on the plane and they all take a gravel and they pass out. And they take off and then they wake up to the pilot going, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be landing in Toronto shortly. And the kids say, look, oh my gosh, look, it's the CN Tower. We're in Canada. And they land, they get off the plane. And then the guy's like, oh, sorry, what? Oh, it's one more plane. Okay, great. Come on, children, get on the plane. We're going to Canada. And then they get on the plane, and they take off, and they're like, wake up, and pass out, and wake up again. And they're like, oh, my goodness, look. Look, it's the lighthouse. It's Halifax. Oh, we're going in, and we're in Canada. Ah. Sorry, what? It's one more plane? I don't think so. I looked at the pamphlet. And on the pamphlet, I saw the mountain, I saw the CN Tower, that was there, I didn't, and then the lighthouse, that's where we are now, but I don't think that, okay, are you sure? It's called what? Newfoundland, Nupula, Newfoundland, Newfoundland, I don't know, it's not, it's made of rock, oh. No, I think we're good here. What, no, we got to get on the plane? No, and they get on the friggin' little tiny plane, they take off, and they're coming down in a snowstorm, and it's friggin' July, bang, and they land, and then they get off the plane, and the mayor of Ticklemearmpits is standing there, he's like, how you getting on? You must be Bhupinder, hop in the truck, welcome to Canada. No! I hate Canada! That's how we got there. But they had the best friggin' cricket team in the Cove, I'll tell you that right now. Nobody could beat them. But that, you know what, it would have been fine because you know the mayor tickled me armpits. You know he was gonna give them a nice welcome. Because Newfoundlanders, do we have any Newfoundlanders here tonight? Yes! They're the kindest, most amazing people in the world. It's so true. And they can tell a story, right? So you know that drive from the airport to Ticklemearmpits was so entertaining for this Indian family. Because Newfoundlanders, man, they can just spin a tail and they don't stop. And you have to be careful. If you're planning on visiting, ladies and gentlemen, you got to be careful not to get trapped in a story vortex. Right? You've got to be careful. Because a lot of times when you ask a Newfoundlander a question, very rarely do you ever just get an answer, right? You can go down, excuse me, sir, can you tell me where the pharmacy is? The what? The pharmacy? Oh, the drugstore. Oh, that's funny. Well, you need some condoms, do you? I know what you're up to. Here's what I do. I like to dip mine in some latex paint. I'm going to go all winter. I'm just friggin' with you. Anyway, here's what you do, me buddy. You go down this road there now, and you see that house on the left-hand side. Now, that house there used to belong to Bob Dodd. Now, we got this little doggy out front. Holy birdie, my son. That little doggy, he look like he'll tear the little face right off you, my son. He come chomping. But you can go right up to him. You can pet him right on the face. He's fine, my dear. And all that foam around his mouth, you got nothing to worry about that foam. That's not because he got rabies or nothing like but that's because we love throwing in a pack of Rolaids every time we go by. Loves the Rolaids, he do. And then a lot of times when I'm downtown partying and I'm drinking, I got the freaking heartburn, my son, like enough to tear you open. I goes over, give me a kiss, Skittles, blah, 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 blah. Oh, it's like taking a dagger right out of me goddamn chest. Anyway, you go past that house, and that half-burnt down house up there on the right belonged to Ridge Douglas. Now, Ridge Douglas, holy dying. Now, he used to be the fire marshal in town, right? The fire chief. And the only way he was allowed to have a smoke was when Ernestine was gone up to friggin' New Brunswick to work up in the fish plant. Well, boy, dying, he got this stuff from British Columbia, and he smoked the one night, he was sitting on the toilet, friggin' passed out, and the friggin' thing caught fire to the toilet paper. Police caught a fire. Jesus Christ, he woke up. He was so stoned, he didn't know what to do. He runs downstairs, picks up the phone to call the fire department. Jesus Christ, kept getting a busy signal because it was the friggin' fire department. Burned his face off. We makes his fun of them all the time. Anyway, pharmacy's up there on the right past that. Listen, you guys have been a lot of fun. Thanks so much.